So for today's technique video, I want to talk to you about how to make a nice smooth bind off in those situations where you're being asked to bind off a few stitches on one row and then a few more stitches on a following row and so on. So you might see this, for example, in like if you're doing a crew neck or a scoop neck on a sweater or an armhole, you know, those instructions where you're told bind off 3 stitches on the next right side row and then 3 more stitches on the following right side row. So here's how you do it in a way that looks particularly nice that they don't exactly tell you in the instructions. So the instructions might say to bind off 3 stitches at the beginning of the next right side row, which I've done. And then I worked across the rest of that right side row, and then I worked a wrong side row to get back to here. I purled across. So now I'm at the beginning of another right side row, and I need to bind off 3 more stitches. So if I just did that normally, like if I just knit 2 and bound 1 off and knit another one and bound another one off and knit a third one and bound it off. The problem is this, that you get this kind of funny stair step thing. And it's basically because you've got an extra row in here that's, you know, providing a little extra height. And it doesn't make, like, if you come back later, say, on a neckline, and you're trying to pick up stitches to, you know, say, put some ribbing around that neckline, it's just not going to make a very smooth surface for you to pick up stitches along, and it can look a little bit, can look a little bit messy. So here's how to do it in such a way that, I'm just going to back up a little bit here, here's how to do it in such a way that you'll get a smoother join between those two points in the bind off. So I'll just back up to where I was at the beginning of the video. So now here I am back at the beginning of the right side row. Instead of knitting that first stitch, I'm going to slip it instead. So I'll slip it purlwise, which means slipping it without twisting it. And then I'll knit the next stitch and bind off like normal. And knit the next stitch and bind off. And the third bind off. And what you get is a much smoother line. And the reason why this works is because if you think about that slipped stitch, you're not giving it that extra height by knitting it. And so it creates a kind of bridge between the previous bound off row and the one you just did. And so that makes a much better edge for, say, picking up stitches or seaming in a sleeve or something like that. All right, I'll see you in a couple of weeks. Bye.